why should anybody be surprised that we are first today? Our heritage is one of immense national pride. The controversy erupted because of the students' sensitivity to the passing of the CAA, of the NRC, or the NPR. India should be proud of that.
Today we are talking to you as a former Vice Chancellor of Jamia Millia Islamia, and not as former Lieutenant Governor of Delhi. What do you think about this success?
Shadab, it surprises me that anybody should be surprised that Jamia stands number one in the rankings amongst central universities. We have always been in the first 10 anyway, and we have been consistently striving to improve more and more in terms of our infrastructure, in terms of our teachers and so on. Jamia is a 100-year-old university. The foundation of Jamia was laid by people like Mahatma Gandhi. When Jamia went short of money, Sir G.D. Birla contributed funds, and Gandhiji said that this university will not shut down for lack of funds. I will travel throughout India and raise funds for this university. Our heritage is one of immense national pride. Throughout the national movement, Jamia's teachers and students have been in the forefront. The controversy, I think, is not a hallmark of anything wrong. The controversy erupted because of the students' sensitivity to the passing of the CAA, of the NRC, or the NPR. And I think that there is nothing wrong with the young, vibrant students thinking about social issues, about political issues, and then demonstrating to make their feelings open to people. That is all that these universities have tried. And I think it's a matter of pride that these are vibrant students who are willing to agitate with their point of view.
So do you feel proud that your students are protesting against something?
No. It's not the pride in the protest. It is the pride in the thought process that the student can define in his mind what is good for India, what is bad for India. You can disagree. The student can be wrong. The student can well be wrong in protesting against the CAA. That's a separate issue. But what is critical is that the student is sensitive enough to think through what he thinks is good for our country. You know, the ranking is done based on the quality of infrastructure the university has. The ranking is done on the quality of work done by the teachers, the papers they have published, how many PhDs we have produced, the games infrastructure in a university. And clearly, Jamia is way ahead in most of these things. Like you say, it will help people maybe think that the controversy was not needed. They will see that our students are good. It will help our jobs. Although, let me again tell you that Jamia students have never struggled for jobs. We have campus recruitments for engineering, for MBA, for law, so on and so forth. So my students are not thirsty for jobs. They will get jobs because they are good. There have been only three controversies in the past 15 years. Number one, 2005, there was an agitation of students that turned nasty. Any university in India could have an agitation like that. Let's not talk about Jamia itself. Unfortunately, in I think it was 2008 when the Butler House incident took place, and my students were not involved. But just because the university has proximity to Butler House, you labeled my university. We have nothing to do with Butler House. So that was unnecessary. Number three is the CAA matter, which is again 10 years later. And like I said, that students across India have agitated on the CAA matter. Lucknow University, Allahabad University, BHU, AMU, they've all come out. Even Delhi University. So to label Jamia in that sense is unfair. But let me again say that an agitation by a student is well within his rights, so long as it doesn't break the law, so long as he is putting forward a point of view. And that's fair enough. It happens all over the world.
How to cope up with these negative targeting, negative, or you can say branding?
I think, Shraddha, we have to step out. We have to step out of our campus. Jamia, AMU, JNU, etc., all these universities must hold seminars, conferences, go out and tell the people what they're all about. It's high time that we publicize ourselves. We never cared. We were happy. Isko kehte na kuch mandu. Hum to khush hain ki hamara campus hai, hamare bachche padh rahe hain, khush hai, taleem ho rahi hai, first aa rahe. That's not enough. I think people must know. When I was vice chancellor, let me tell you, and in those days, foreign universities were not allowed to come. But I traveled to America and to England, and there were universities who were keen to collaborate with Jamia. That's the reputation of Jamia. I will, through your medium, congratulate the vice chancellor, Ms. Akhtar. I will congratulate all the teachers and the students for the effort that they have put in these last 2-3 years to build it really into a first-class teaching institution.